Hey guys, can you hear me? Is it like good compared to the background music? I'm live from the kitchen. I told my roommates that I'm doing a monthly Zoom cooking class. I lied. Peace, I to lie. It sounds fine. Okay, it should be fine. I just get really anxious. Also, hi, Kobobo! Of course you're here first, of course. Classic! Guys, new tweet, go like it, por favor. That way everybody knows that I am live on Zoom. Guys, this is Zoom, right? This is zoom.com. Also, while we're waiting for the stream, can everybody make sure you're subscribed to my YouTube channels? Even if you're a long-term fan, click the links in the pinned chat, youtube.com/@peaceandseventeen and @peaceandseventeenclips. Even if you don't watch, just subscribe, please. Por favor. I've been practicing my Spanish, and I'm actually pretty good. Me gusta hablar español. but I do Duolingo in the morning, and then really late at night. So, like, whenever I do the talking challenges, I'm like, me gusta bailar. ¿Dónde está el baño? I do want to do a stream where I test my Spanish knowledge. I want to take a mock AP Spanish exam. I think that'd be really funny. You know what else is funny? I was trying to think of something like clever, but the only thing I could think of was your mom, which is kind of funny. Guys, face cam on in 30 seconds. Not even joking. Also, my phone's like almost dead. Okay, I have to get the last of the ingredients for a bit. And by bit, I didn't mean joke, I meant like span of time. Okay, face come on in 3, 2, 1. Everybody clock in. Guys, I'm live. Good morning. Nope, it's not morning, it's 4 p.m. Good afternoon, good evening, hope everyone is doing well today. Hello, Keelan. Hello, Kobobo. Welcome in, both of you guys. Hope everyone is doing well. Live a bit late, because I didn't get a lot of sleep. I fell asleep at like 2, and then I woke up at 4, because I had to go with my sister somewhere early in the morning. So I'm very tired. I also spent a lot of time at the grocery store. Very tired. But I'm here! Also, the lighting looks a bit better. The last time we were in the Meg Esports kitchen, the Million Dollar Kitchen, was about a year ago for Christmas, and the lighting was horrible. Brace yourselves, flashbang. So this is with all the lights on, but look how chill this one is. With just 2 lights on. Very nice. Will we need 911 on speed dial? No, I won't set off the fire alarm this time. I promise. Hands are not crossed. I promise. Dude, what are those silly little billies doing? Okay, I forgot to feed the cats. My sister's probably like leaving out cat food. Okay. The plan for today is simple. I will be baking a pumpkin pie for the first time ever. Yes, that is true. Never baked a pie. Pumpkin pie, just looking at the recipe, is like the easiest pie. It's basically like custard. You don't even have to like pre-bake the crust. Because I was getting really nervous. I was like, don't you need like those little weighted balls to make crust? But apparently for pumpkin pie, you don't need to pre-bake it. So that's cool. Today's spread. You can see my Alienware laptop. That is necessary for baking, obviously. Oh, wait, imagine I was muted this whole time. Okay, so today's recipe is courtesy of tastebetterfromscratch.com. It was like the third result on Google. I know how to make a pumpkin pie in Minecraft? Well, that's more than I know, man, honestly. I never played Minecraft, and I never will. So, this is the best pumpkin pie recipe. This is the description. Just not my opinion. Hashtag not an ad. The best pumpkin pie recipe is perfect in every way, and you can choose to serve it with a simple homemade caramel pecan topping that takes it over the top. I'm not doing the pecan topping. Nobody in the house likes nuts. And not the fun kind, okay? So, equipment. You need a pie pan, which I have right here. I got these round cake pans. They're 9-inch last year because I was gonna make cakes for my sister's birthday, but then she just wanted a Safeway cake. Ingredients. You need a 1 9-inch pie crust, 2-pack, baby. 3/4 cup granulated sugar, 1 teaspoon ground cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon salt, 1/2 teaspoon ginger. Oh, I have ginger. 1/4 teaspoon ground cloves, 2 large eggs, 15-ounce can of canned pumpkin, and 12-ounce can of evaporated milk. So I was looking at different recipes, and this one seems like it'll be the sweetest. I don't necessarily like a overly not sweet pumpkin pie. I have a sweet tooth. So all the other recipes I found didn't have sugar. Which I think is an L. I love sugar. So, this one has sugar and evaporated milk. Because a lot of the other recipes I saw just had evaporated milk in it. Okay, instrucciones. I don't think that's how you say it in Spanish. I'm gonna mute real quick. Okay, clear the chat. Okay, coast is clear. Wait, how do I hide the chat on screen? Okay, it's gone. Clear. Cleared the chat. Back to work. Where was I? Okay, there's 5 steps in this recipe. Very easy. And one of the steps is making the pecan mixture. So technically only 4 steps. Step number one, preheat the oven to 425. First thing you do, obviously. And the oven we have in our kitchen, it takes forever to preheat. It takes like 20 minutes sometimes. So So we're gonna do that first. 425. Oh wait, before anything, I must get my apron on. The classic cooking mama apron. Oh wait, I think my head's too big. Hold. We're good. Now I am ready. Okay, oven is set to 425. It's gonna take about 15 minutes to preheat. So, step numero dos. In a large bowl, beat the eggs and pumpkin together. In a separate bowl, combine the sugar, cinnamon, salt, ginger, cloves, and add to the pumpkin mixture. So my spread today, I have 100% pumpkin puree, fat-free evaporated milk, pumpkin pie spice, because I didn't want to buy 3 bottles of spice for today. Also, I had this from last year when I made eggnog with my friend. 2 eggs, and then pie crust here. Only other thing I don't have on the table is sugar and salt, which I can grab momentarily. So I need a large bowl. We've been here for almost a year and we still don't have, like, actual mixing bowls. Okay, I have large bowl. And guys, we have a second camera. Oh, the mic blocks it. Cringe. There we go. That looks a little bit better. I don't know. I'm new to this. I don't do cooking streams. Okay. So we combine the eggs and the pumpkin together. Now, the strat when you're cracking eggs, whenever you're doing multiple, it's fine if you're cooking for just yourself, but a good habit to get into if you are cracking, like, 3 or more eggs is to crack the eggs separately. Because sometimes, I haven't had this happen yet, but you can get like a dead or like a partially fertilized egg, which you don't want. Sorry, that was which you don't want. So to avoid that, you're gonna crack your eggs into a separate bowl before you put it into your larger bowl for mixing. Ooh, clean! Holy! So then, this is in our separate smaller bowl. Place it into the larger. Okay, that one wasn't as good. Little bit of shell.
Which came first, the chicken or the egg?
Which came first? Obviously the egg. I hate this debacle. It's literally so dumb. Actually, DOM. Like, dinosaurs had eggs. Okay? But thank you for the resub, Keely with Prom? Ain't no way. Can we get some wheelings? Wait, 9-month resub? That's a new sunflower badge in chat, guys. Let's go. Just eat the shell like the rest of us? What does that mean, Ethan? Explain. Are you like, you don't want to get your hands dirty and dig the shell out? Come on. Welcome in, Ethan. Can we get some yos? And thank you once again for the resub, Keelan. Donde está los alerts? Where'd I put the alerts? Oh, the alert didn't play. Sorry, I'll replay it for the fans. Who takes the eggshell out? What? I will never eat any food that Ethan eats, I've decided.
Came first, the chicken or the egg?
There, I replayed it so now you can see it. Say thank you. Okay, and as with like, whenever I crack an egg, I do have to like rinse my hands after. I think it's like gross having like the icky stuff on your hands still. So I don't like medium rare chicken nuggets? No. No? Huh? I'm never going to Ethan's potluck. Okay, so a smart person, even though it tells you to like combine, you know what? The camera, I don't like this. I'm gonna make it smaller. There we go. Also, like, do I sound okay? I'm not talking super loud. Anyway, even though it tells you to combine the pumpkin puree with the eggs together, still probably a good idea to beat your eggs a little bit before you put the puree in. Oh, no, I'm so dumb. Oh my God. Large bowl, small spork. What do you expect? Oh my God. Dude, I cannot. Medium rare chicken nuggets, it's fancy. No, that's just a lawsuit. Hey, pumpkin puree. Okay, I saw a TikTok video that said even if you don't have the fancy can openers, you can still open it like this. And I try it and it still doesn't work. So we're opening it so all the trash collectors will get their hands cut. In a friendly way. I'm not doing this on purpose. Justice for the poor eggs that get beat up every day? What about justice for me? You guys bully me every day. Can we get a hashtag justice for peace in trending? This is a dull butter knife. Don't do this at home. Or have your mom take the lid off the can. Ooh, that's. Oh! It's not sweetened. Hashtag justice for eggs. That's not the one I want trending. That's not the one I want. Chef Peace, yes, sir. Hi, Mac. It's hard to see chat. I have it at this largest size and I still can't see. Hi, Mac. Can we get some yos? Everybody, clock in. Clock in. You're learning today. These are called turners, not spatulas. Okay? Spatulas have the little slits in them. These are turners. Add that to your vocab cards. Where to clock out? I'm trapped. You guys have to stay here forever. That's how it goes. You have to watch the whole broadcast. I'm gonna be in and out. No problem. Okay, so now we're gonna combine our puree with our eggs. Is anybody baking along at home? Type one. Those are rubber spatulas? No, they're not. I literally just explained that they're turners. Spatulas have these slits in them. That's why there are different types of spatula. There's the fish spatula, there's a turner spatula. The ones without slits are called turners. And I learned that from a YouTube video, so it must be true. Hi, potato. Welcome in. Can we get some yos? Zero? Wait, why are we typing zero? I forgot. What did I say type one for? I forgot. Okay, wait, so this was. Wait, this has a pumpkin pie recipe on here. Dude. It has one on here. Okay, so now we are going to combine our puree and eggs. Oh, you're typing zero because we're not baking at home? Oh. We ain't bakers? Not am I. Neither am I. I really want to use a whisk, but I hate cleaning whisks. Wait, you guys wanna. You want some ASMR? Ready? Does that sound good? Thoughts on the Mr. Beast Rosanna Pansino situation? I'm indifferent. I understand, like, reality television, which is kind of what Mr. Beast videos are. They're edited to look like reality or, like, commentary videos, right? So I understand that some of it will be, like, exaggerated or faked. I definitely think it's valid for her to feel like her work wasn't respected, or she herself wasn't respected. But I understand why people think it's silly. But just because outside people think it's silly doesn't mean it should be, like, normalized for that behavior. That's what mac and cheese sounds like? Yes, sir! Yes, sir! Okay, so eggs and puree is thoroughly combined. Next up... She was, like, the only woman to make it that far? Why did they cut her? I don't know. She's on the record? For what? For what? Don't at Hassan Abi. Don't at my favorite streamer. Come on. Okay, next. In a separate bowl, combine sugar, cinnamon, salt, ginger, and cloves, and add to the pumpkin mixture. Very important. Always mix your dry separate from your wet. Because whenever... Oh, wait. Sugar. Wait. Sugar is technically a wet ingredient. Because once you add sugar to liquid... It decrystallizes. So why is having us mix sugar separately? Peace, iTunes. Okay, I lied. The oven is preheated. And it's only been 10 minutes? I lied. Peace, make a drama channel? No. I ain't doing that. No. Mm-mm. Okay, so I need salt. I need teaspoons. I am never going to buy plastic measuring spoons again. Oh, wait. Because, like, all the labels washed off in the dishwasher. Very disappointing. Okay, so I have my salt and my pumpkin pie seasoning. Because the pumpkin pie spice is cinnamon, nutmeg, allspice, ginger, and cloves, I'm just gonna do the total amount, which is half and then a quarter, so 3/4 teaspoon of pie seasoning. Sugar's a plasma? I don't know what that means. I need a half a teaspoon salt. Well, this is large coarse grain salt. Uh-oh. That could be a problem. Also, it's very important when you're baking to get level scoops, which I am not doing. Don't forget the wasabi. I hate those little flowers in Mario Wonder. Some of them are quirky, and then half of them are just literally saying the dumbest shit. Yes, curse word number one. And before anybody asked, no, I did not do the dishes early in the morning. I was tired. I will do them later. And by later, I mean tomorrow morning. Okay, this is half a teaspoon. So I need 3/4. That's about half. And then sugar, I need 3/4 cup sugar. We bought this whole bag a year ago, and I've only used like 3 cups of it. All of my larger measuring spoons don't have the labels on it.
Oh no.
Okay, the only way I know, just guess, okay, the only way I know how to tell my measuring spoons apart is I have the largest one cup in our rice container. We have a large Tupperware that has a bag of rice. And then the second largest is 3/4 cup, next is 1/2 cup. And then 1/3 cup, 1/4 cup. So, in order for me to know which measuring spoon to use, I have to have them all clean. I was like, I legit can't think of another way to label them. Like, I could put tape on it, but then germs would build up. So I don't know. Okay, 3/4 cup sugar. If you can't tell, I'm a pro baker. Now, if I'm using the 1/4 measuring cup and I need 3/4, how many scoops do I need to make? Whoever guesses correctly wins $5. And there's also a $5 delivery fee, so technically you win zero. Now we mix 17. Oh no, 4? Oh no, guys. You're supposed to be back in school already. Okay, looking at this, this is a lot of sugar compared to the amount of puree. Now, ideally, I would use a whisk, but I don't like whisks. I wish whisks would go away. Okay. Thoroughly combined. Now, once you have your dry spices mixed, add them to the pumpkin mixture. Done. Okay, I'm gonna gradually mix this in, because I don't want... Ooh! You can see it, the sugar's like melting. It's morphing. I'm no kitty who goes to school. You should go back to school, bozo. I like to stick with forks to whisk. I agree. I think one of the most influential videos or TV shows I watched as a kid was the Ruff Ruffman show with Ruff Ruffman. And it was, they were tasked with like cooking. And the kid, he was showing off to whisk eggs. You do like horizontal motions instead of circular. That way you can get a better motion with the actual egg. And that has stuck with me for, how old am I? 18 years. I love that show. I know. I think, because that was like one of the first few like kid-based reality shows that was on like public network TV. Because I didn't realize it, but the reason why I grew up watching a lot of reality TV was because in 2007 was the first, one of the first major writer's strike. So that's when a lot of broadcast television was airing reality TV. So that's kind of what I grew up on. Okay, it's almost fully combined. Thankfully, no clumps yet. You know, this looks like slime gone wrong. Wink. Okay. Okay, I think that's fully combined. And notice how when I'm mixing, I'm scraping my sides. That's why you use a turner to mix. You can use a whisk or a fork to mix, but you're going to want to use a turner to scrape your sides. Especially when you're working with a mixture that is primarily dry ingredients, you're going to want to make sure you mix your sides and the bottoms, that way you don't have any dry lumps, because it will affect the overall texture of your baked good. Don't fail the pumpkin pie. I think just based on the recipe, it's very hard to mess it up. Also, you know what's not easy? Or, you know what's also very easy? Following the channel, because guys, we are 30 minutes in the stream, so follow. You get cool emotes, and you get to type in chat. Wow. Okay, next. Gradually stir in the evaporated milk. Carefully pour mixture into the pie shell. Okay, I'm using fat-free evaporated milk. Oh, I forgot to do a close-up of all the ingredients. Oh well. Because now that I know how to budget a bit better, I've decided to, instead of buying the cheapest ingredients, I'm trying to buy things that are more healthy. So base ingredients that have less fat or less sodium, less sugar. Because you can always season later. Oh, this is like pure liquid. Uh-oh. I thought evaporated. Oh wait, I'm thinking of condensed milk. Condensed milk is the gooey one. Okay. The recipe does say evaporated milk. Imagine I get the wrong one. I would just like end stream. Okay, slowly mix in the evaporated milk. So I'm adding about a fifth at a time. This is when having a stand mixer would be great, but they are way too expensive. Oilers. I'll put that on my wish list this year. Santa, if you're there. Editor, zoom in on the wink. Dude, this looks so good. Wait, I was gonna say, technically there's nothing raw in here, but there is eggs. Do not eat the raw batter, guys. Don't do it. I know the cookie dough looks tempting. You can literally buy cookie dough that is meant to snack on. A hand mixer works well. I'm too scared of hand mixers. My mom would sometimes use it because she had a hand and a stand mixer. And anytime I would use a hand mixer, it would just like go crazy. You know, just looking at this combine is kind of satisfying. Why are we typing nom nom in the chat? This is not a UW chat room, guys. I don't want that to be the meta. Please. This looks like way too much filling. I was gonna say earlier, this doesn't look like enough, but this is kind of a lot now. I really hope my pie doesn't overflow. I got all the right amounts of everything. That's the one thing I like about capitalism, is that they have, like, different sized containers for, like, most everything in the shop. It was also really difficult to not buy, like, pumpkin-themed foods at the shop. Because they had pumpkin cheesecake, pumpkin muffins, mini pumpkin pies. Oh my god. I'm trying to eat less sugar, I promise. But what I did tell myself was that if I'm going... Also, this shadow is from the cork. Let me fix that. Oh, you can still see shadow. Oh, that's better. Okay. What was I gonna say? I'm trying to eat less sugar, but I refuse to buy sugar-free things because I don't know what the faux sugar is called, but it leaves like an aftertaste, quote unquote, but it's actually just like your brain not receiving the dopamine hit as quickly as you do from real sugar. It's all in your head. It's all pseudo. But still, like, artificial sugar just will never do it for me. Okay, this is fully combined. No lumps. I've been scraping my sides. Now, let's make the pie dough. Just kidding. I have store-bought. It was also, like, kind of sus because I shop at Winko. This is Winko branded for us. Like, they will leave, like, the boxes that come from the shipping manufacturer, like, as part of the display, which is fine, I don't care. But, like, half of the pie crust boxes they had on their shelf were open like this. So I had to, like, dig to the bottom. I was like, how are these, like, still on the shelf, but they're already open? Because they had, like, there was probably a case that had, like, 100 of these. Like, half of them were already open. Yes, they are, like, individually wrapped, like, plastic ones. But still, I was like, uh-oh. Who's trying to eat the raw pie dough? Okay, so, pumpkin pie only needs one dough crust, which is kind of nice. So, first we are going to grease our pan. Now, last time I used Pam, I made the mistake of spraying it over the floor. So I got oil all over the hardwood floors, which is very difficult to clean. So, I'm gonna use my brain and spray it over the sink. Easy. Yeah, it was not fun. I'm gonna put gloves on. Not that I wanna be safe, I just don't like the feel of stuff on my hands. Because this is just for my roommates. So that's why I'm not wearing a mask today. I'm not cooking for a mass group of people this time. And no, I will not be doing cake pops this year. My sister lost her job, so we don't have people to give the cake pops to. Are my roommates gonna rate it? Probably not. Because in order to serve pumpkin pie, you have to wait for it to be fully cool. So it takes like an hour to cool. And my sister doesn't like pumpkin pie, my roommate does. And then the other roommate said they didn't want any. Okay, so this is a 9-inch pizza dough. Wait, what if I just went like this? There's crumbs all over now. Okay. I'm gonna put flour side down. As I said earlier, for this recipe, you don't necessarily need to pre-bake the dough. Which I love, because I don't have the materials for that. So, as you can see, I'm pressing my thumb gently against the bottom edge as to not tear the dough. I also have longer nails today, so I have to be very careful. Okay, so I'm going to make my pie crust kind of fancy. And I will be using the second dough, because I had an idea. Since I am making pumpkin pie, why not make the pumpkin pie look like a pumpkin? Watch till the end to see. Okay, so I think I'm gonna do like... How do you do this? Wait, I'm doing it. Oh my god, I'm doing it. Oh, I tore it. Wait, how do they do it? I'm trying to... Okay, that looks pretty good. Close up. That looks pretty good. This is my first ever pie. Be nice. She's not gonna be perfect. So bad. Okay, I think that's as good as it's gonna get. A simple curum. Am I gonna do lattice? Lattice would not do good for custard pies because the dough would sink into the actual filling. So it would affect the like final texture of the actual pie, because even though pumpkin is pumpkin, it's still a custardy because it has the evaporated milk in it. So no, I cannot do lattice. If this stream does well, I will do pie streams every single day. Okay, let's go. This is like way too much filling. This is way too much. Oh wait, it's perfect. Okay, this bowl is ceramic, so it's really heavy. I'm doing my gains today. Okay, since we're using our rubber spatula, turner, gotta get as much as we can off. Can't waste a single drop, not a single grain of rice, not a single drop of pumpkin pie filling. Okay, that's good enough. Oh! Look how clean! I didn't spill a drop! Okay. I'm gonna move the chair so we can actually see the oven. No screenshotters, okay? Okay, so now that we have our pumpkin done. Oh wait, sorry. My sister needs to grab water real quick. I'll right back. It'll take like 30 seconds. I'm back. So annoying. Okay, back to it. So, in order to make my pie look like a pumpkin, I'm going to use the second pie crust to add some leaves and vines and a stem. I just can't have the decoration go on top of the actual custard. And I will use the rest of the pie crust at a later date. Because usually I'll use pie crust for like little egg bites for breakfast. Oh, it's so floury. Okay. So I'm going to make a little stem. This is gonna be cute, I swear. Hopefully it doesn't like burn. Oh, that looks so, I should have done this before. Okay, wait, just wait. I'm gonna use food scissors. I don't have food scissors. I personally don't like them because their blades are usually a bit too thick. So usually I just buy like a pair of like larger adult scissors, not kindergarten scissors, adult scissors, and I reserve them just for food. So I'm going to cut a few strips. Dude, this is totally going to burn. Kitchen shears are so good. I don't like them. They're too bulky. should have put the vines and then the stem. I'm gonna cut a leaf. Almost cut my glove. This looks so bad. Okay, this is my little decoración. Oh, this is so liquidy. Can you guys see it? I don't want to tilt it. Yeah, I'll just zoom in here. There you go. So this is my pumpkin pie ready to go in the oven. So whenever you have something that could potentially overspill in the oven, or if it could splash up, you're always going to want to put it on a tray. That way, if it does happen to leak, it'll leak on the tray, not on the actual bottom of your oven. Is it a goose? What? It's supposed to be the pumpkin head or the stem. Oh, I laid out the tray already. Okay, our pie is on the tray. Everything is safe and secure. Now for the moment of truth. Bake at 425 for 15 minutes and then reduce temperature to 350. Okay, it's going in the oven. As we know, we turn on the fan so we don't set up the alarm. Okay, she's in. Now we wait. Timer for 15. Okay, timer set for 15. Also, guys, this is a real cooking show, right? So look what I have ready to go. I have a pie already done for Jet. Look at that. Look at how beautiful she is. I made this one earlier. Wink. Look at that. Is she pretty? No, okay. This was $5. I bought this just in case my pie was like actually bad. I put it in the oven when I lied and I said my sister wanted water. Oh no, good bit, type one. Cause like, okay, you know how when you watch a cooking show, like you watch Rachel Ray at 1 PM and like she puts the casserole in the oven and 10 minutes later, she pulls out one that's completely done. And the only reason why they do that, they pre-make a good one in case the one they make live is bad. And also like, just to make taping not last 2 hours. So yeah. That's my pumpkin pie. Not you cheating? I'm not. Okay, it'd be different if I lied and didn't confess to lying. Okay, let's clean up my station. Besides me, L, I asked you guys if I could do this bit yesterday, and you guys were like, haha, that'd be so funny. You guys are just fake friends, fake fans. Now I'll have so much to eat. Don't worry. You see this? Max said the bit would be funny. Oh. You know, if I have one person in chat say something will be funny, I just think everybody thinks it's funny. I always forget that people will, like, click off and, like, make hate threats. Yeah, I'm gonna clean up my station a little bit. I'll wash dishes later. We're not gonna put on little YouTube videos as I wash dishes. We're gonna do an activity as we wait for the oven. You keep the oven light on? I usually don't. I just want you guys to see that the oven is on. Just for a little, like, cinematic effect. And yes, this is going in the hamper. Plot twist, I have another one. I use towels instead of oven mitts, because with towels you can layer them to have, like, it be one layer thick, two, or four, depending on if you're grabbing, like, a larger pan from the oven. You can also put it over your shoulder. It's a lot more convenient. You can put them here. Because a lot of oven mitts that I've used aren't thick enough. So, and also towels are just easier to grab. And also easier to clean, too. You can just toss them in the washer versus, like, an oven mitt. Like, y'all know, you guys never wash your freaking oven mitts. Be honest. When was the last time you washed it? Huh? Use a towel. And now we wait. As we wait, I bought something special for Jet. I bought it as an impulse purchase today. I got a puzzle. I haven't done a puzzle since I was like 10. So this... 1,000 pieces. It is... 72 by 52 centimeters. Any EU viewers tell me what that is, please? That's about like 2 by 3 feet, right? So we're gonna start this and I will finish it, surely. We'll do this while we're waiting for the oven, just so we have like a little visual ASMR as we wait. Okay, almost ready. It smells delicious already. Okay, I'm going to move SD camera. There we go. That looks a little bit better. Because it's not as bright out today, so we're not going to be flashbanged by the window. Okay, let's get this party started. I look so short sitting down. Okay, also, this box is like perfectly shaped. Look. It's like slowly sliding out. It's so satisfying. Clean! Also, the pieces came in a resealable Ziploc bag. How sick is that? Y'all know you just keep the pieces loose in the box. I know y'all do. I'm gonna move the computer a little bit. Hashtag not sponsored by Alienware. Guys, this will just be like the people who make like Lego builds on stream. It's just like that. And yes, that is the tape covering my webcam, hackers. Okay, let's get started on this puzzle. Wait, so I think the total big time... Yeah, the total big time is an hour. But we have to change the temperature throughout. Let's just do this. Classic. Yay. Oh, I don't want to do this.
I just remembered I hate puzzles. Okay, so what you do first with any puzzle... Oh my god, this is so much. I chose one that was trees, and I thought it'd be easy, but like, looking at all the colors on here, they're way too similar. Oh no, I messed up. Okay, we're gonna separate all our end pieces. This is 1,000 pieces. Dude, I cannot. Okay, I'm gonna try and adjust the color filters on the secondary camera. Ooh, deep fried. Okay, that looks a bit better. Whoa! That was for the meme. I feel like that looks like a tad better. I don't know. It's because this USB camera is solely like... I cannot make it so it captures more warm colors, like my DSLR. Because the DSLR has like... integrated color correction. Or like different color like filters like on Instagram and stuff. Okay, back to work. Oh my god, this is so much, dude. I think the largest puzzle I ever did was 500 and I quit. Oh my god, dude, why did I think this would be a good idea? Okay, sorting out all the end pieces. You know, this is how people had fun before they had cell phones. Ooh, and end piece. What did we do before the internet? Like, honestly. Oh, wait, I'm supposed to, like, sort by color. Oh, but since, like, the picture is trees... I'll show the picture. Since the picture is trees, the colors are gonna be too similar. Oh no, why did- I should have chosen the pumpkin one, because there was like literally like an easy looking jack-o'-lantern one. Oh, woe is me. You know, I like sorting, but I never liked sorting puzzle pieces. Wasn't my jazz. I like sorting the cars more than this, and the little alphabet blocks, and Lego pieces. So, what have you guys been up to this pleasant Monday? There's been frost outside every day for the past few days, and I'm getting really sad. Because I don't mind winter, it's just way too soon for frost. Whenever I see like a puzzle kit at the shop, I just like to think the designers just made it like an impossible puzzle. Like, none of the actual pieces match. That'd be such a funny prank. Or imagine selling a coloring book that is already fully colored. I also think that'd be funny. Don't worry, when I release my coloring book, it will be blank. I won't do the prank on you guys. I would make the colored version only available in Hallmark stores so I can... in Hallmark stores, so I can troll all the 50-year-old white women. I'm kidding! Unless... The cold is so relaxing, though. I used to think that, and then I became old. Now the cold just makes my bones creak and crawl, and I feel like I need a walker. Or that I need to call my grandkids. Hi, Kim. Welcome in. Can we get some yos? Also, hi again, Mac. Can that pie, like, hurry up already? I want to eat. While I'm sorting, guys... Make sure you're subscribed to my YouTube channels. I have two channels. youtube.com/@peaceand17 and then @peaceand17clips. Daily YouTube videos on daily YouTube shorts on the Clips channel and weekly highlights on the main. Subscribe. Hashtag ad. I paid myself $500 just to say that. Please make it, like, worth it. I'm down 500. In my name. Yeah, this is awful. I should have gotten like a Halloween coloring book. I think that would have been more fun. No, I'm having fun. Smile. You know, once I get past the sorting out the end pieces, I think this will be more chill. Because then I can sort by color. And then start matching. Oh, that was an end piece. An NPC? Guys, I'm never doing an NPC stream ever again. Even if I hit the sub goal, I'm not doing it. And no, not today's sub goal. I said I would do an NPC stream at 2500. But I lied. I'm not doing it. Too embarrassing. I sent the VOD link to my friend and they blocked me. As a joke. And then they unblocked me. You know who is gonna get temporarily blocked? The non-subs. Because guys, we are an hour into stream, so it's time for me to run some ads. You can avoid that ad by subscribing for $4.99, just $5. Skip your coffee and get ad-free viewing all month long. Or you can link your Amazon Prime to your Twitch and hashtag sub for free with Prime. Click subscribe. See if you have a Prime sub available. Or maybe you'll get lucky and get a gifted.
Get boomed.
Bussin? I hate that word. Or more in particular, I hate B-U-S-S-Y. I hate that word. At Emmy Beef in the chat. She says it all the time and it triggers me. Oh!
Also, I was kidding. Yes, bussy is a blog term. I literally explained in the past. Even if it's not a bad word, I will ban words I don't like. Okay, back to the recipe. Reduce the temperature to 350 and bake for 40 to 50 minutes until the pie is set. Okay, so 350. The oven is set to 350. Now we set a timer for 40 minutes. Man, that's a long time. Okay, timer set.
She was gonna block BBL.
I still don't know what that means. Is it bad? I'm clueless.
Get back to work.
Oh.
I got a BBL for my birthday?
Holy moly.
My explanation got blocked? Good. I don't want bad words in the chat. Back to work. Okay, it's getting very hot in here. But keep your clothes on, please. So, who likes puzzles. I love puzzles. How is butt with two? Okay, Chatter, use your little brain. How is butt with two T's blocked? Dude, go back to school. Didn't you drop out? Jeez. You know, I might as well block butt with one T. She cooked you? Yeah. See, we talked about this yesterday. I roast you guys. You guys just type Lomao. I love it. Such a head scratcher. Dude. Can I be honest? I was having a really bad day today. And goofing and gaffing with y'all always makes me happy. In a non, like, parasocial way. I love roasting. Also, I'm going to a job fair with my sister on Thursday. So I probably won't be able to stream Thursday, or if I do, it'll be like in the late evening. I might do a sub only on Thursday for the fans. This puzzle would take a 9 to 5 to finish it, just like the pumpkin. Oh wait, I posted a video of the bedazzled pumpkin I made on stream yesterday, and dude, it looks insane in natural light. It's on my Twitter, but Twitter botched the quality. It could still be on my TikTok or my Instagram stories. Exclamation souls in chat. But it looks insane. Like, I put it in my windowsill and it looks so pretty. Am I gonna finish the pumpkin? I actually might, like, just like for fun. Or if I'm like feeling in a sorty mood. Cause it is kind of sad walking past the pumpkin in the window and I see the unfinished part, and then people outside see the gem part. I might actually finish it. Not on stream, though. I think that'd be a bit much. If I was smart, I would sort these inside pieces by color, but that requires too much brain power. Why didn't I finish the pumpkin? Because I asked chat. Once I hit the little over halfway mark, I was like, guys, can I bail? And they were like, yes, sir. And I was like, thank you. And then I ended the stream. And then I played Mario Wonder with my favorite sister. My sister's so cute. She really likes the Mario Wonder game. And she usually doesn't like 2D platformers. But I'm really glad she likes it. She was gonna, cause we have like a small living room by the kitchenette. Oh, a corner piece. Oh my god, holy. She was like, can I play Mario Wonder and then you can watch me like from the kitchen? And I was like, no, I had to unplug your Switch dock because I needed the outlet for stream. Are your sister and I caught up to World 4? Not yet. Another corner! Not yet. I don't want to play further than I have on stream. She and I just got to World 2, Fluff Puff Peaks. We're getting there. But like, we're not doing a lot in a sitting. We only play like an hour every day. You do real puzzles, but not puzzle games? When have I ever said I liked puzzles? And when have I ever done a puzzle on stream? Watch every single VOD and clip me saying I like puzzles. I've been an avid puzzle hater. The only reason why I bought this puzzle today is because it was on sale for $5. And it was in the impulse buy section of the store. So I bought it. Like a sucker. Oops. I'm chucking pieces everywhere. I was jamming to pop songs on my headphones, and I saw the puzzle, and I was like, I need this. And then I bought it with my sister's money. So basically, me buying the puzzle today was the delivery fee for buying groceries. You know, I get a $5 tip, and I chose to buy a puzzle. Which I love. What if instead of selling paintings, I sold puzzles? Would you guys like that more? Type 1. I'm doing market research right now. No. Okay, I won't make a puzzle then. But what if I made it like... Didn't Mr. Beast have a puzzle? I remember there was some puzzle online to where if you finished it, then you got, like, money. David Dobrik? Oh. More like, David Lodbrick. Oh yeah, it was David Dobrik. Oh yeah, the QR code puzzle. See, I'll do that, and I'll just make an NFT. Oh, wait, Meg. I thought you were calling me white, and I was question marking in my head. I would like a coloring book, though. I'm adamant about making a coloring book, like, legitimately at some point. Like, if I ever have a large enough platform or a large enough demand to, like, sell, like, 1,000 units, then yes, I will make a coloring book. Because whenever you get things manufactured, they have, like, a minimum amount of units you have to purchase or manufacture from them. Because it wouldn't be profitable for, like, or as profitable for a manufacturing company just to make, like, 10 units. So, guys, if I get 1 million subs, I'll make a coloring book. Or what if I just made coloring books? They'd probably... I've thought... Nobody steal the idea. But the idea I had was... selling, like, a watercolor coloring book. I don't know if this has been done. But, like... make prints of illustrations on, like, high-quality watercolor paper. And then sell a watercolor coloring book. I think that could be kind of fun. Thoughts? Or like, I could sell the same coloring book on different types of paper. Like one for like markers. Because different types of paper will absorb ink differently. Like, you know how copy paper, you can see like the ink bleed all the way through versus like cardstock, it doesn't bleed as much. I think that could be an interesting idea. You would need super thick paper. Exactly. But then I also realized that people who buy coloring books aren't necessarily like artsy, from what I've noticed. It's usually just normies who want to like zen out for a bit. Not many crafters buy it. I'd buy printout pages, it's relaxing. Yeah, I would probably sell a book and then probably sell like bundles of illustrations that can be printed. I think that's what I'd most likely do because I understand like, I don't necessarily like coloring out of a book because you know how when you have the bind of the book, like the part closest to the crease will never like be fully flat and that really bothers me. So usually if I've had a few coloring books, like usually they'll have like a perforation. So I would just tear out the coloring page and color outside the book. Are there any coloring books that have like a spiral binding instead of a glue? Because I think a spiral bounded coloring book could be kind of good. That way you have like a flat surface, you don't have a curved paper. See, why am I thinking this far into it? It'll never happen. Unless... Ooh, another corner! That's 3 out of 4. Unless there's somehow more than 4 corners in a rectangle. Wait. Together? I think the most annoying toy they would have at recess would be a puzzle. Cause no way! All the puzzles in your shared toys at school have all the pieces. So dumb. Or like going to Goodwill, you open a puzzle box, no way they have all the million pieces in it. No way. Not for real? Yeah. Hashtag relatable. You know what I just realized? This is our, like, dining room table that I moved over into the kitchen area. If I start the puzzle, I'm not gonna be able to, like, leave it on the table. It's about the journey, not the destination. Is what I'll say. So if I have to put this all away in 2 hours, I'll be fine. I won't cry myself to sleep again. Surely. I was at the bus station this morning, and there was a little Zoomer waiting for their bus. Because at some of the bus stops, they'll have, like, the actual, like, the city school, or the city bus stops. They'll have, like, the actual, like, school buses pick kids up at, which is annoying. Because at some stops, there's, like, 20 little Zoomers waiting for the yellow school bus. And they sit on the bench for, like, the normal bus people to use, so then I can't sit. And it gets annoying. But anyway, there was one little Zoomer kid, and they were watching, like, Schlatt videos at full volume at 7 a.m. at the bus stop. As, like, 10 other kids are waiting at the same stop. It's like, yes, I love Schlatt, but, like, do you have no shame? Or maybe that little Zoomer was like, I hope one of these other kids also likes my favorite YouTuber so that we can become best friends. And make it our whole personality. What videos? Oh, I wasn't, like, listening. I knew it was Schlatt because I recognized the voice. They were watching Schlatt and Markiplier. That gives Cole Bobo vibes? Why are you calling people out? Be nice. Since you're not here all the time, Kim, you gotta be nicer. Only regulars are allowed to be mean and roast. How do you not know who Schlatt is? I'm here often? Let's check your logs. Just kidding. I know you have a job. Imagine having a job. Couldn't be me. TBH, you're not a regular? Ooh, drama. Are you guys gonna file for another divorce? I saw her texting mad late in the group chat. Okay. If you guys are gonna, like, chat amongst yourselves offline, just don't be fucking weird, okay? I don't have a official group chat. I have an official Discord, so just don't be weirdos, okay? I don't want, like, an expose coming out about my community members being freaks. Too late? This is why I don't want a Discord. It'll happen one day. Maybe it'll be a Christmas miracle. If you guys write it on all of your Santa's wish list, maybe it'll happen. Oh my god, this is actual, like, shellac music. I had a whole listening party conversation. From what I can tell, I think Kim is a drama farmer. You're gonna become a toxic viewer one day, and I'm dreading that. Okay, if you guys have an offline group chat, how many people are in it? How many people are in it? I imagine it's just, like, all of my regulars. Three? Oh, it's you three fucking weirdos. That's two. Yes, I did use my allotted swear. The fourth puzzle piece! It's only for the cool adults? Surely. Nah, we'll have a Discord when I get a million subs, don't worry.
Guys, we're meant to be showing why it would be so amazing to have a Discord, not the opposite.
Dude, Keelan is begging. See, I'm not gonna say that. I'm stalling. I'm doing the long burn strat right now. I'm withholding affection, that way when you guys finally get it, you'll appreciate it a lot more. It is not emotional abuse, it's just me setting boundaries. Will you play Roblox with us when you make a Discord? No! Roblox is for children. Oh my god. The cool adults play Roblox. Wow. Okay, I'm almost done sorting. I almost have all the edge pieces. Guys, if I ever go on a date, I'm gonna make me and my date do this puzzle. And then we're gonna smash. Gizzard? I'm so tempted to, like, open the oven and look at the pie. But usually with any baked good, it's not good to open your oven throughout. Because anytime you open your oven, you're kind of ruining the seal of heat. And it's especially important to not open your oven whenever it's a baked good. Smash on the puzzle? Yes. Clippers, have fun. We're so funny. Okay, all my pieces are sorted. I think I got all of the edges. Now let's get to work. This is our base picture. Yellow and blue. I thought this was the prettiest puzzle, but now looking at it, this is gonna be like the most difficult. Okay. usually, like, puzzles will have, like, a printout of the actual picture. This one did not. I think I'm gonna have to stand. Ew.
Getting my steps in. The pie is looking good. Who looks at it, a 1,000 puzzle piece puzzle and says, that looks easy? I looked at it and I thought, oh, this could be fun for stream. Let's get to work. This part blocks the- it says ages 10 plus, and it blocks part of the picture. That's so DOM. Like, legitimately. Okay, so this is my top right, bottom right, top left, bottom left. Okay. Just got to work. First try? Ain't no way. Yeah, first I'm gonna flip all my edge pieces facing up. Ooh, I can smell the pie now. What if they sold you a puzzle with a missing piece, that's why it was on sale? It was a sealed box? So unless somebody tampered with it like the election, then I think this is fine. I'm kidding. I love Biden. Teehee. K. Kona. Dude, I need to stop making jokes like that. Like, with my friends and stuff, like, I joke about, like, right-wing politics. Like, I do K. Kona, funny joke. But then I understand that, like, people who don't know me might not think that. Wait, do I have... Okay, I do have LGBTQIA tagged. It is my second tag. Okay, so more warmer colors are going to be, more reds and darks are going to be on the right, and then blues and yellows on the left. Dude, this is going to take forever. Everyone who watches you is super gauge. I mean, I agree. Honestly. Wait. Another one. I'm not? What? Were you lying, Mac? You know what I think about liars, right? Another one. Oh my God. Perfect. Dude, I'm cracked. Oh, that doesn't work. Dude, how are you supposed to, like, commentate as you're doing a puzzle? This is so dumb. I think I'm missing one. Oh, wait. That's it. Am I gonna be live on Thanksgiving? I don't know if we're gonna celebrate Thanksgiving this year. Easy! You can say something like, I am now picking up the corner piece, and I am now putting it into the puzzle. Dang it. Wrong piece. Like that? Is that good? I'm always home for the holidays? That's good. Enjoy that while you can. Did you even celebrate Thanksgiving last year? Last year, we went to a buffet with my roommate's parents. We did not go home for Thanksgiving. And I don't want to go home. Cause drama! I think I'm missing this piece. It's in here. It's fine when you stream on the holidays? I don't think I've ever streamed on a holiday. I've done holiday streams. Oh wait, I streamed Christmas Eve. That kind of counts. I had the Christmas stream open when I was with my family. Oh, that's so cute. Hopefully I didn't swear too much. They're like, is that the person you watch all day at work, Kobobo? En serio? Watch this. Okay, that- Oh, it fit! Holy. Wait, does Kobobo not have a jaw? Okay, this fits, but that doesn't look like it should. Zoom in. You're not gonna be able to zoom in. this doesn't fit. It fits, but... Oh, wait. Because there's like a white patch here, but that's because I tore some of the print off. That's my fault. You have a completely remote job? That's great. That's kind of the dream. Ayo? Dude, this is gonna take forever. I don't wanna do this. Yeah, I still don't understand how you don't have headphones, Kobobo. Like, for remote work, like, do you, like, talk to your boss on speakerphone? Like, what? That to me is crazy. Like, legit. Boss? Hey, yo! Another corner. Thank you.
You know what? This is oddly satisfying. Oh my god, another one. The amount on the table versus inside the box is stressing me out. Okay, bear with me. It's been like 14 years since I've done a puzzle, bozo. Like, come on. I have a pie in the oven. I made dinner earlier. I'm a tired housewife. Okay, Kobobo, if you can afford to gift 84 subs last month, you can afford to buy little cheap-ass headphones. Swear number three. Like, come on. Come on. Ooh, easy clean! Girl can afford wigs but not skull candies? Wait, Kobobo, you have a wig? That's kinda cool. I've always wanted a toupee. I have been losing a lot of hair recently. I love stress. Wait. Nope. I bought a wig. Yes, sir? Dude, looking at this store-bought pie and not wanting to take a nibble is very difficult right now. You know what is not difficult? Following the channel, because guys, we are another 30 minutes into stream, so if you're new here, follow. You get cool emotes, and you get to type in chat. Wow. Oh, you bought it for a costume? Okay, are you gonna go as Barbie? Everybody's doing Barbie this year. I wanna be a girly too. I'm Brooke. Wait, watch this. Watch this. Oh my god, clean! How long does the pie take to cook? A total of an hour. And it's been probably, my guess, about 40-ish minutes, so about another 10 to 20. I'm not checking my phone, because whenever I check my timer, I get anxious. So I just let it go. Elsa. 2016? 2015? My clocks went back an hour yesterday, so now it's getting way too dark too early. Wait, was that this week? No wonder I've been messed up. Wait. Watch this. Clean! I was playing Mario with my sister yesterday, and I kept on saying clean whenever I did like a really good line. And she's like, what the frick are you saying? She does not swear. And I was like, clean! Like, my lines are so clean like Mario Kart? And she's like, I don't get it. Then I cried. You know, I wish my sister was a Twitch watcher. She fits the demographic. She has no job. Teehee. Watch this. Oh my god. Why doesn't she swear? I don't know. She's on the spectrum. So she has a really weird moral compass. It's not, okay, weird is not the right word. Because there's some people who are on the spectrum who are like very adamant about following rules. Which she is for the most part. Like she's very like by the books. And she does not swear. The only swear I've heard her say was shit. In reference to like actual shit. Wait, that's five! Editor?
Oh, yeah, I thought it said on my calendar that daylight savings is next week. Oh, guys, I have jury duty next week. Just reminding you, don't forget to subscribe. Watch this, watch this. Oh my god, Colleen! Yeah, I was so annoyed because whenever I get my depo, I have to get every 3 months for my BC. Not birth control, not anything else. God. So, my appointment was on Monday, and I was like, shoot, now I can't get my depo shot. Thankfully, I have a 2 week window after Monday to get my shot, so I'm just gonna get I called and rescheduled for sometime in the future. Because with depo, if you don't get it within like a 3 week time frame, after 3 months after your previous injection, it can make your cycle start again, which I don't want because I hate blood. Dude, I'm not even gonna get the border done. Jury duty stream? I have no idea what that is. Imagine. Dude, it's kind of annoying because for jury duty, it's by county. So, all of. Oh, that's a horn. So, majority of the cities within the county I live in go to the same building. So, it's not just people in my city. It was doubly annoying because they sent my jury duty card to my parents' house, which I don't know why, because I literally changed all my addresses with the city when I moved, because I moved cities. Like, I changed all my addresses, but they still sent it to my parents' house. It was so annoying. Like, my dad texted me a picture of it, and I was like, thank you. Can you send me a picture of the bag? And then he was like, why? Can't you just pick it up? And I didn't respond. And then 5 minutes later, he sent me a picture of the back of the card, so then I could register. But it's like, take my addresses to avoid this confrontation. Thankfully, my parents aren't too aggro. Because my sister still talks to them, so like, they'll vicariously hear updates about me from my sister. TLDR, if you need drama, my parents weren't the nicest to me, is what I'll say. Obviously, there will be things I will share and some that I won't. But they weren't the nicest. Actually have a TikTok clip coming out in a few weeks that kind of addresses one of the major issues I had with my mom. And I was debating whether or not I wanted to post the clip, but then I was like, it was already set on stream. Like, if people really wanted to go through VODs, they could go through it. And I think it was a really good discussion. Or it wasn't a discussion, it was me telling a story. It was me, spoilers, talking about why I really heavily think or greatly think about connotation of words. Because there was a. My mom got mad about something. I don't know what it was. This is when I was like a junior in high school. So like 17, 16, 17. She was getting mad and she was like, I hate you. No, I resent you because resentment is so much worse than hate. And the way. Oh my God! Time to check on the pie, guys! Stay till the end to hear the story. Let's check. Forgot to turn on the second cam. Look at this butte. Okay, so it says it'll be completely done once the filling is set. It is not set because I can see it kind of falling in the center. And my fork is still wet. So it is not done. The crust itself is not burnt, so I will check it in another 10 minutes. Timer set. I thought you said it would take 15 minutes. I said 50! Dude, get your ears checked. Or get headphones. Or maybe your computer speakers are broken. Classic Cool Bobo not listening to what I say. Classic. Okay, anyway, going back to what I was saying, my little sad story. My ugly duckling story. Editor, cut this out, please. Or watch the TikTok clip. She said, I hate you, no, I resent you, because that's so much worse than hate. And then ever since that moment, that is literally the moment when, like, word and what people say to me, like, I hyperanalyze, gave me anxiety. So, like, that's why, like, I don't... Okay, I jokingly say I hate chatters sometimes, but I generally don't mean it. You can always tell I'm joking by my tone and inflection. But, like, I'm very mindful with what I say. Like, there are some times when I do slip up, but for the most part, everything I say has a purpose to it. But then, in turn, I overthink and overanalyze, like... I think the best analogy is, you know how when you play a story video game and there's like five options for what you can say to the character or the NPC? That's kind of what goes through my brain whenever I have a conversation. Because I cannot help but to think of how my words affect other people. Yeah, so don't say you hate your family. Smile. Why did you think 15 minutes was a normal amount of time? Cool Bobo's a college dropout! I'm sorry. Dude, I can't. This is too much. This is too much. Why are you wowing? Dude, I can't do this. You guys can't even see the freaking puzzle. I can't do this. Complete the puzzle, impossible difficulty. Wait. Pause. No! Was this a waste of $5? Type 1. Oh my god, dude, I cannot. Wait. No! 100% perfect puzzle run ruined. Wait. No! I think that's the same piece I put in earlier. I can do it for you? Someone's sub went to this? You don't think this is amazing content? Dude. I think I'm missing another edge piece. Because I'm looking at like the shape of the actual rounded edge and I can't find it. Wait. No! This is so dumb.
Nope.
Dude.
I think it's Jover. Wait! Clean!
I'm back on track. I'm back in.
I'm hooked. I love gambling. Oh, wait. Clean, clean, clean. Yes, sir? Oh, wait. This one? I'm really good at figuring out which piece blob goes into the hole. Editor.
You've gotten farther than I thought you would? Dude, I'm like... Shut up. I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22. I'm 25 pieces into my 1,000-piece run. I'm being for real? No, you're not. Stop. Why are you glazing me up right now? You're making good progress? Guys, stop lying. Just because it's Halloween doesn't mean we can be naughty and lie. But keep glazing me up, please. I need the encouragement. I like praise. Oilers? Or sugar mamas, please. This one looks like it should go here, but it doesn't. Este? Hey, yo! Dude, my sister got slippers because it's cold and she walks so loud upstairs. Oh my god. Este? Hey! Oh my god, clean! Yes, sir. I'm in. Dude, that was like a 4-piece run. Another one. DJ Khaled. Again. Yes, sir? Are puzzles supposed to be done solo? I feel like puzzles are meant to be a group activity, right? Colleen! Yes, sir? My whole family does it together because they're big. That's cute. My family would start screaming at each other. Mine would too, honestly. But for other reasons. Yeah, it's not gonna fit on screen. Guys, if I hit 1,000 subscribers, I will do a 1,000-piece only white puzzle.
No joke. I'll do it for the fans. And I'll title this stream, Watch Peace and Go Live. Wait, no. Dang it. Watch Peace and Go Crazy live on camera. How? They sell puzzle sets like that, just white. Insanity.
What is that? Time to check on the pie.
Pie is complete.
It's still bubbling too. Look at her. Such a beaut. I also love seeing like the custard kind of crumbling apart at the edge. I think that's really pretty. Not the ideal texture you want, but I love texture. I love abnormalities and most anything. I think it makes things pretty. Because there's no such thing as perfection in nature. There it is. The pie is done. I should not be touching it with my bare hands. What if I drop the pie? That would be an amazing clip, but I don't want clout today. Look at her. Isn't she beautiful? Okay, for some reason, like, our back right burner of the oven always gets hot whenever the oven's on, so I'm letting it cool on the left side. And to have it cool even faster, I'm going to put my tray on a cooling rack. Let's actually get a close-up. The custard isn't fully set, so I can't tilt it too much. Better zoom in. You! Screenshot! Someone screenshot for me, please. It smells good. It also makes a great hand warmer. It's cold inside. It looks great, thank you. I really like it. I'm proud of it. Maybe I'll make more pies. Do I have whipped topping? Yes, I do. I have peppermint and then Cool Whip. But you shouldn't cut into a pumpkin pie until it's fully cooled. Because since the crust isn't pre-baked, if you cut it too soon, the custard won't set, and also you're gonna tear your crust. So I have to wait an hour for it to cool. So, guys, I think we'll pause here for today. And run an ad, because we are 2 hours into stream, so it's time for me to run some ads. You can avoid that ad by subscribing for $4.99, just $5. Skip your copy and get ad-free viewing all month long. Or you can link Amazon Prime to your Twitch and hashtag sub for me with Prime. Click subscribe, see if you have a Prime available. Maybe you'll get lucky and get a gifted at some point. Yes, I fell off. The subathon was a month ago. I have no more subs, guys. I'm broke. Okay, so, I'll be honest, I don't I don't want to stall for an hour for it to cool. So, what I will do is once the pie is completely cooled, I will post pictures to Twitter and on my Instagram story and on my TikTok story. So guys, follow those accounts right now. But I have another pie ready to go, actually. So we can cut into this bad boy, the $5 pumpkin pie. Screw this puzzle. What if I just went pop? I ruined it. What should I do with the puzzle? I don't want to keep it here. What do I do? Wait, I can tape it. I'll tape it. Okay, let's go like this. Okay, as I said, I will cut into the pie I actually made later once it's fully set, and I'll post pictures on socials later. But I'm gonna take a bite of this bad boy. $5 cheap pumpkin pie. It has a tin. I only put it in this for the bit earlier. Editor, cut back to it. We love callbacks. So today I have Cool Whip Light, because I'm trying to cut back on sugar, but I forgot to thaw it. I don't know if frozen Cool Whip is still usable. And then I have peppermint flavored whip topping, Winkle brand, on sale. I was like, screw it, I'll try it. Taste testing both, live. Let's cut into this bad boy. You guys can actually see. Dude, I need to figure out how to frame these kitchen streams. It's so hard to figure out how to angle everything. Okay. The pie did burn a little bit from the bit earlier, so sorry. Ooh, Colleen. Controversial, but I don't like pie crust that much. It's not my favorite. Skinny slice, because I don't want to look fat. I like the setup. I do too, but there's a lot of empty space here. Majority of the things were on this side of the screen. But, you know, I'm not a filmographer, is that what it's called? Ooh, watch this. Colleen! Pac-Man. Abba, mama? Hey, that was not the right game sound. Am I supposed to shake this? Oh, shake can gently. It's waka waka. Oh wait, you're right. Okay, it says shake gently over the sink. Editor, blur this please. I don't want this on camera. I've always been scared of Cool Whip cans like this. I've always been scared that they're gonna explode. Okay. Dude. Colleen. Okay, so this was peppermint topping. I don't know how good peppermint is gonna be with pumpkin. So I have frozen Cool Whip, Winkle brand as well, because I'm broke. You know, there's no shame in buying school or You know, there's no shame in buying store-branded product. To me, they all taste the same. If you're broke, to me, it doesn't matter. Food is food. Oh, this is really frozen. This... It's like ice cream. I'll put it next to it. Look, pie a la mode. Okay, I want to try some just the co-op like this. It's literally like ice cream. I should have let that thaw in the fridge. It tastes really good frozen though. And how much sugar is in here? 2% sugar? Wait. Okay. What if instead of buying ice cream, I just ate frozen Cool Whip? Winkle brand Cool Whip. 5% saturated fat and 2 tablespoons though. That's kind of bad. Let's get a taste of this bad bite. I'd like to re-clarify, this is not the pie I made. This is the store-bought $5 pie. I'm gonna try the peppermint Cool Whip first. Ooh, this actually is so good. The peppermint isn't like too strong. It's very subtle. That'd be very nice on like... a cocoa. Okay, $5 pumpkin pie. Is it any good? Pretty damn good. The crust, like, tastes burnt, though. I really hope my crust doesn't taste burnt. Because that's what I don't like about, like, a traditional pie crust. They always taste burnt. Okay. The frozen Cool Whip, very nice texture when compared to the pie. This is technically going to be my dinner for today. Along with the other piece of my actual pie that I'm going to eat later. I really want to cut into my pie, but I'm scared of ruining it. Ooh, it is fully set. Like when I... Okay, the pie is still very hot. It's fully set, because when I put my finger pad on it, nothing, like, pushed back. It was bouncy. Ooh, I'm so excited to try. Should we stall for an hour just so we can watch my reaction live? $5 store-bought pie? Pretty good. Pretty damn good. What now? I think I don't want to stall for an hour. I'm tired. So what I will do is I will like film my reaction to taking a bite. And I'll post it on Twitter. Or editor, put the video here now. Okay, now we're back from the imported clip. So once again, thank you to hashtag not an ad. Tastes better from scratch for today's recipe. It is the pumpkin pie recipe you can probably find through Google or if you go to their website. Another few things to note. Store-bought pumpkin pie can sit at room temp because it's in a sealed package, but if you make pies at home, make sure you fridge it and have it in a fully sealed container or saran wrap it properly. And you can also freeze it for up to 3 months, it says. But if you're gonna put it in the fridge, it's only good for like max a week. 3 to 4 days, but let's be honest, max a week. This was a lot of fun. It's been a long time since we've done a cooking stream. This was nice. The puzzle. We will never talk about this again. And I'll do it in my free time for relaxation. But thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for watching. That was all the flour I inhaled. Okay. We can chill for a bit now. Editor, cut. Editor is gonna be me, guys. Do we have any editors in chat who would want to be paid nothing? You get paid in exposure. Okay, so this was a lot of fun. The second to last stream of Wicked Week 2023, I will be streaming tomorrow. No leaks. It's gonna be a weird stream. I promise you, it's probably gonna be the weirdest stream I've ever done. And not in like a good kind of weird. It's a really obscure bit I have planned for tomorrow. Oh, it's gonna be wonky. So I should be live again tomorrow. Probably in the afternoon. Maybe 11 if I get it done in time. I have to prep a good handful of stuff for it. Don't worry, stream is not over yet. We get to do calligraphy because we had somebody redeem and we had a resub earlier. So guys, if you want me to write your name, all you must do is subscribe or use your channel points and I will write your name for free. Any redeemers? Bye, Kim, unless you practically said bye. Slay! Okay, I'm gonna put the puzzle pieces in a bag. That way I don't have to resort them later. When I come back to this. As I'm getting my coloring utensils, I want you guys to think of streams that you would like to see during Christmas time. The plan for November, I have jury duty the first week, so I don't know how much I'll be able to stream next week, because jury duty is like literally all day. And it's kind of BS, because whenever you get called for jury duty, you literally cannot call out unless you're like dying. And you only get paid $10 a day. And sometimes you have to pay to park in the parking lot. The Grinch game? What is that? If that's a game I can buy, send me a link to like the Steam link, Kobobo. Or if it's a video, send me the video on Twitter. Think of ideas, guys. I need your help. Santa needs help this year. Thank you. It's a $40 Switch game that sucks.
You think that's in my budget?
In serio? You think I'm rich?
Look at my sub count! Making Christmas cookies? I could do that. That is an idea. I'll do it. Once again, thank you, Keelan, for the 9-month resub. Another rare sunflower chatter. Thank you. Now time for the brokies. Who wants attention? Okay, this is our last name of the day. If you want me to write your name, all you must do is use your channel points. And last call. And last call. It was cute, because I was setting up for stream, and my sister was like, "What made you think of the stream for today?" She's so cute. Maybe you could make ornaments?
I could try to make ornaments from, like, scratch. I could try that. Guys, your homework tonight is look at Christmas-themed things to do on Pinterest, and then give me, like, 5 of them. That's your homework. Extra credit. We stan your sister? Yeah, one day you'll see her. I did tell her, if I ever make money, I will sponsor her trips, and then she can be a travel blogger. Dollar Tree sells clear ornaments. I still have clear ornaments from last year. I still got them. 5 things?
Yes, if you want extra credit. If you want to be the teacher's pet, then yes, 5 things. And she said she still wouldn't show her face, because, like, she's considered filming whenever she's done, like, her normal trips. Like, dude, imagine Japan vlogs. Because, like, if I could sponsor her, like, if I ever had money, like, if I had a really good job, or if streaming ever pops off, or YouTube, guys, sub to the YouTube. YouTubers, watchers, click subscribe. Like, because a Japan trip would cost, like, max 4,000. Because she knows how to budget. So many other streamers are doing candy tier lists. Yeah, they saw Ludwig and they were like, I'm gonna do that too. But I did that last year. I didn't do it this year. Because I'm not gonna double dip. But I'll probably do a tier list next year. Because I'll probably have new viewers by then. Hopefully. What was I gonna say? Yeah, she said if she ever made vlogs, she would have me narrate them. Imagine me in your little ears. Be like, today, we're going to Osaka. Look at this bidet. Can you do a weird candy cane flavor? Ooh, I'll write that down. That actually sounds fun. But you guys have to promise you will not screenshot me licking the candy canes. No screenshotters. I can do that. Let's see. Okay, deleting all my Halloween stream ideas. Not like you're gonna do it? Stop. What about screen recorder? No screen recorders! I've seen too many COO tributes on Twitter, and it makes me scared. I always report those accounts whenever I see them. I don't give a fuck. Frick, that's 6. Editor? Weird candy cane. Man, my phone auto-corrected weird to word. Samsung has gone woke. Okay. Christmas streams. I think I will wrap it up here. I'm tired. The pie is still very hot. Don't touch it. I will film whenever it's fully cold and I will eat it. And I'll post it on Twitter. And YouTubers, it will be in the video. I'm gonna wrap it up here for today. Thank you all for watching any Chatters Liquors. I hope you had fun today. Kitchen streams. They're fine. The most annoying thing is, like, bringing everything downstairs and then back upstairs. That's legit the most annoying part. But it is hard to find a time of the day where, like, nobody wants to use the kitchen. But today worked out fine. I'll be live again tomorrow. Undetermined time, probably, like, 11 till afternoon. Depending on what time I get the prep done. You know the drill, I stall. I love the kitchen streams. Thank you! I think they're chill. It definitely gives M-O-M-M-Y vibes, and I don't know if I want that. You know, I want to be desired. I'll see you tomorrow. What's tomorrow's streams? I leaked it yesterday, and you weren't paying attention. Moms are desired? Yeah, but I don't want to be called that. What? Really? Yeah, the one time Kobobo tabbed out of the stream. I mean, all that you guys need to know is that it's going to be a weird stream. It's a very weird way to execute the thing I'm doing. Do-do-do-do. Do. Okay, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.